Welcome to our first virtual interview of the StAREAST conference. I'm excited to have all of you with us, and I'm excited we have Alison Wade, the president of TechWell, with us. So thanks for joining
us. Great to see you, Jennifer. Thanks.
Thanks
for having me again.
Let's talk a little bit about, for the folks that are out there that aren't here live at the conference, some of the things we're seeing just as trends, you know, in terms of attendance, who's here. You know, they don't get to see all the folks, so give them a little insight maybe into how that's going.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, StAREAST, it's been a bumper year for us. We have an increased attendance of about 14% over our previous StAREAST, which is great numbers. So we have well over 1,000 people here today. And we had about 3,600 people sign up online to watch the conference. So they're going to be coming in virtually at different parts of the day. And this morning during the first keynote, there was over 750 people online watching in an Eastern time zone. So it's been really a terrific conference so far. Great numbers and a lot of energy, a lot of fun people.
Yeah, that's amazing. So for those of you that are out there kind of interacting virtually, the nice part for you throughout the day today and tomorrow is, besides the keynotes, we'll be talking to folks like Alison and the speakers and getting you some insight into what they're thinking and what's going on. And one of the really exciting things, I think, that's in its second annual event is our Women Who Test.
Yes.
So can you tell the folks out there that aren't familiar with it, you know, kind of how you started this, what, you know, kind of the mindset was around doing this?
Absolutely. About a year and a half ago, maybe even more like 2 years ago, I attended actually a Google Tech Makers Conference, a Women Tech Makers Conference, and I saw how much was going on for women in development, software development.
Yeah.
And obviously that's a very different ratio. I think it's a ratio of 10 to 1. So, you know, female software developers are hard to come by, and the industry and companies like Google and Microsoft are realizing how important women are in this equation.
Yep.
It's not just a feminine issue, it's a social and economical issue. I mean, they're 50% of the population, and when you're building products for you know, a divided gender population with 50% women, 50% men, you have to have women's input. It's imperative that you have their perspective and their input. So I saw a lot of this going on, and I felt like there just wasn't enough going on in the testing community.
Mm-hmm.
You know, there is a little bit few more women in testing than there are in the development community, like a 7-to-3 ratio.
Oh, wow.
But still, I felt like, what can I do to support the women in this community that I've been a part of for 20 years? So I put this day together, and it was at StarWest last year, and it was such a successful day. You were there, Jennifer. The women loved it. First of all, you know, any time that you get to talk to people that have similar experiences to you, it's just a great time for people to hear from other people, feel a lot of camaraderie, talk about the issues that they have personally and how they solve them, and learn how other people have solved them. So they're coming together first as women and secondly as testers.
Yeah. Well, and I know, having been a part of that first day, it was the energy in the room when you get a group of people together and you can talk about some of the topics that were on there. Like, the one I thought is interesting for the folks out there, if you haven't seen it, was the panel you did on career superpowers.
Yeah.
And talking about that and the book. So for folks out there that might not be familiar with that, maybe talk a little bit about, you know, what that looks like, the career superpowers, and, you know, what that session was kind of geared towards for people.
Sure. We put together a panel of women. There was actually 5 women speakers at the event. Jamie Newberry was one, and I'll just sort of give you a little bit of outline of the day. She did a talk called Redesigning Your Life, and basically what she was talking about was a time when she experienced a tremendous amount of burnout in her career. As she was a mom, she had a lot of things that she was balancing. She was super burned out. And how she sort of got herself out of that funk and back into what she loved, which was software design. She used the methodology that she uses to design software to sort of bring herself back to life, I guess.
Yeah.
And it was a very inspiring story. We had Melissa Benua talk about being the, sometimes as a tester, you're the lone voice of reason. You're the one that has to say, stop, this is not good enough. There's a problem. We can't ship. But what's it like when you're not only the lone voice of reason, but you're the lone female voice of reason?
Mm-hmm.
That sometimes can be incredibly intimidating. And she gave everybody just totally practical tips about what to do and how to communicate in an environment where you may be the only female. And that was really terrific. Then we had Tanya Katan, who was hysterical, so funny. She's actually a real-life stand-up comedian who now has a job with a software company called Exosoft, and they started a fabulous campaign called It Was Never a Dress, and basically they took that little bathroom icon of the lady and revealed what was really under there all the time, and it was a cape, of course, and it was just a fantastic visual, and I actually wore that t-shirt through the airport, and I got so many comments on that t-shirt, and people just really, it really sort of felt empowering to women to see that symbol.
Well, and I think they gave out little stickers for your laptop.
They did.
And I have the one on my laptop, and I tell you, everywhere I go, people look at that sticker and they ask me about it. Men and women, like anyone, thinks it's so neat to see something reimagined that we looked at one way and can see it a completely different
way. Absolutely. Yeah, I had a lady come up to me in the airport. She must have been like 70 years old, and she looked at my t-shirt and she's like, oh my God, I wish they had that when I was young. That's so cool. Like, what a great affirmation.
Yeah, so for folks that haven't seen it out there, it's called It Was Never a Dress. It went viral.
Yes.
I mean, it was all over. So if you haven't seen it, go check it out. It's so neat if you haven't seen
and
it.
And it's basically women in technology telling their stories on this site, on this website called It Was Never a Dress. And it's fantastic. And then we have you doing a session on branding, which is just really awesome because I feel like women don't think about their careers enough. Back to the career superpowers. Yeah. One of the career superpowers is to plan, to think about your career, to treat it like a job. Mm-hmm. And so often women don't think about their career in that perspective, to treat it like a job or a marketing campaign or all those other things. Right. And that is one of the career superpowers. Mm-hmm. And Jennifer does a great session on branding, and it was really helpful. People loved it.
Yeah, I think it's so interesting to me that naturally a lot of women are very giving and they give a lot of themselves in their careers and their personal lives. And then, like you said, sometimes we forget about how to take care of ourselves,
right?
You know, and build that brand for ourselves and treat ourselves the way we do everything else in our life, which is to make sure we have a plan and take care of it, nurture it, and make sure we have a goal in mind at the end of it.
Yes.
So great session for those folks that aren't able to attend. You kind of got a good rundown on what will be happening in that day and Women Who Test. There's also a way that they can get engaged if they're out there, right, with Women Who Test with the blog or...
Yes, if you go to a Twitter at Women Who Test, we also have a LinkedIn group, and there's also a website, womenwho.com. womenwhotest.com.
Yeah.
So you can go there as well.
Yeah, so they would have an opportunity to go out there and take a look at that.
Yeah, absolutely.
And see what's out there, so for those of you out there. And now, what are the plans for the future? Do you see, will this be at more events?
So yes, absolutely. And I think I missed telling you about that. When you first asked like why we started, I got sidetracked by the Google Tech Maker thing. But one of the original issues was when we look at the number of submissions we get for, say, a StareAST program, we get over 350 submissions.
Wow.
But somewhere between 10 and 18% came from women.
Wow.
And I was, you know, thinking, you know, obviously there's a population difference in the tester community, but even then it was incredibly unrepresented.
Yeah.
And so I got some help from actually a few great men who helped me find really good women out there who were testers and asking them to speak. And I felt a lot of hesitance on their part to tell their stories and to talk about themselves. You know, I think that men sometimes have a much easier time touting themselves, talking about themselves.
Right.
It comes quite naturally. Women sort of don't do that as well. So it's a learned skill.
Yep.
So in working with some of the women, and I'm pretty proud to say that there are now several women who have become speakers at the STAR Conference as a result of efforts just to help get speakers in.
Yeah.
And in particular, one's really exciting, and I got to write down her name. Yasi. I can't remember her last name. She's a director of QA at Cvent, and she approached me about speaking at the next Women Who Test at Star West.
Wow.
She has an amazing story to tell about her career and her life, and she came to Women Who Test at Star East, and she was inspired by that day and wanted to speak, and she just did a great write-up about what she wants to talk about. So Yasi will be talking at Women Who Test at Star West, so that's really awesome.
I mean, what a great story. Like you said, just to be able to get more people engaged and be comfortable telling their stories.
Yes.
Because there are so many great stories out there, and it always helps to hear those stories from other people who are in similar situations and, you know, have had similar experiences.
Definitely.
You know, and that unity of that. So that's awesome and great to see. So very exciting. So the plan is that every STAR conference going forward, there'll be a day dedicated to this. So STAR West, STAR East will both have these days. So for folks looking at getting funding or capability to come to one in the future, plan for that. And it's included.
It's free. So it's there on Friday. It's free. It's available. If you come to the rest of the conference, you can just add it on to your conference package. And if you're local and you want to attend and you just want to attend that, you can come just to that
event. That's amazing. Yes. So for folks out there that may be watching that are local to the Orlando, Florida area that can get here for Friday, is there still room?
There is still room.
There's still room. So you can still get in on Friday if you're out there and interested, which is great.
Yes.
And then you'll get a bit of a chance to see some of the energy here in person, too, and what goes on, you know, when you're live here at the conferences.
Yeah, and just go to our STAR East website, and you can click on the registration and register for that. And if you can't get in for some reason, just tweet me at A Wade, S-Q-E, A Wade, S-Q-E, and you can, and I will be happy to respond to you and give you and get you signed up.
Any last words of wisdom, advice for anyone out there who maybe wasn't able to attend, wasn't able to get funding to go to one of the conferences, is struggling? Things you guys have seen that helps in promoting and getting people more on board and leadership for sending people to conferences like this?
Well, I think it's always a challenge. I was we had a test manager training meeting the other day, and there was a gentleman who was telling me, you know, every year he talks to his boss about wanting to come to the conference. They, you know, and he wants to get his employees to come, and they all, you know, they're on board, they get the budget, and then the boss says, you know, like, okay, why don't you just go and bring back the experience to everybody? And, you know, that's great, but it's just not the same. I think the one thing about coming to a conference is it refreshes you, it inspires you, you get to talk to your peers, and you come away with a new perspective. So I think if you're an employer, think about that for your employees, how valuable a week away doing this sort of stuff can be.
Yeah.
There's a little bit of money involved, of course, and a little bit of time involved, but it's so worth it if you can get your people here to hear from other testers, learn what they're doing, and of course the return on the investment for your company can be huge in terms of what they can learn and what they can get out of the conference.
Wonderful. I think that's great advice. Thanks, Alison, for being with us and
welcome
the interview, and I hope you all stick with us for some more interviews later today.
Thank you.